Now let us discuss about virus. The term virus is derived from Latin, which means poison or venom. In 1886, Adolf Meyer observed viruses in tobacco plants, and the viruses were TMV, tobacco mosaic virus. Viruses are ultramicroscopic, very simple, acellular, intracellular disease causing entities. They are made up of one or more molecules of DNA or RNA enclosed in a protein coat. They are able to reproduce. They are obligate parasite. They have no metabolic system. They do not respond stimuli and do not grow in the usual sense. In fact, viruses are smaller than the smallest bacterial cell, and they do not have cellular organization, but they are able to maintain genetic continuity and undergo mutations like living organisms. They are the obligate parasites and cause number of diseases in human beings, animals and plants. Therefore, they are of enormous importance. The study of viruses contributed significantly to the molecular biology. Nowadays, workers from various fields like genetic engineering, plant pathology, human pathology, animal pathology, microbiology, immunology, molecular genetics, and biotechnology are taking very much interest in studying the viruses. The study of viruses is occupying an important position as a major branch of science. The rapid progress in the study of viruses is achieved only due to the development of sophisticated techniques of ultracentrifugation, X-ray crystallography, and electron microscopy. A number of new viruses are reported. Recently, coronavirus, etc. A number of new viruses are reported, and several genetic aspects of the bacteriophages are established. Methods for preventing and curing viral diseases are developed. Despite of these progresses, a question regarding their biological nature is still remains to be solved, that whether they are living or non-living. Now, a brief history of viruses. A Russian botanist Ivanovsky in the year 1892 gave the first demonstration about the presence of some unknown electromicroscopic disease causing organisms. He obtained an extract of tobacco leaves suffering from mosaic viruses, then filtered the extract through finest bacteria proof filter and injected the filtrate to the healthy tobacco leaves. Then the injected the leaves developed the mosaic disease. Therefore, he demonstrated that the agents responsible for the tobacco mosaic disease are filterable and smaller than the smallest bacteria. Then Bejerink in the year 1898 confirmed the Ivanovsky's findings and suggested that the injected fluid itself was the agent responsible for the tobacco mosaic disease, and it was not any submicroscopic particle. He called the injected fluid as contiguous vivum fluidum or living infectious fluid. Pott and Deherle in the year 1915 to 1917 used the term viron or virion, a Latin word meaning poison. The term viron or virion to describe the disease-causing particles present in the infectious fluid. Stanley in the year 1935 was isolated the TMV, tobacco mosaic virus, first in crystalline form. Now, general characteristics of viruses. So here, these are general characteristics of viruses. What are these? Viruses are obligate parasite. Viruses are not free living. They live and multiply only in living cells. They have no cellular organization. They do not have cellular organization, that is, protoplasm and cell organelles are absent in the viruses. They are simple and simple in structure, having two parts only, a central core of nucleic acid, DNA or RNA, and outer protein coat called capsid. Look at the slide. They have no independent metabolism. Viruses do not have their own metabolic system. They have no growth and division. They do not increase the size, only their genetic material divided that too inside a host cell. They have nucleic acid. The nucleic acid as genetic material is present. It may be either DNA or RNA, but both are never present in the virus. They have chemical like nature. That means they can be crystallized. Even in crystalline form, they retain their infectivity. They are specific in action. That is, they always infect particular organs of a particular organisms. They give response to stimuli. They give response to external stimuli, that is, they react with various environmental conditions like heat and ultraviolet rays. They have a definite shape and size. They have definite shape and size. They are seen only under electronic microscope, and hence they are called ultramicroscopic. Generally, the size varies from 10 micron to 300 microns. They have variety of shapes such as spherical, polyhedral, cylindrical or rod-like complex viruses. A virus consists of two parts such as capsid and nucleic acid. The capsid is the outer coat of a virus. It is made up of a specific protein. It is composed of many similar small units called capsomeres. It provides shape to the virus and also gives protection to the nucleic acid. The central core of virus contains a single molecule of the nucleic acid, either DNA or RNA. Some viruses are covered by an envelope which contains lipids and proteins. Such viruses with envelope are called as the enveloped viruses. The viruses without envelopes are called as the naked viruses. Now, chemical composition in the viruses. Chemically, the viruses are nucleoproteins, which consists a proteinous capsomeres and nucleic acid. The nature of viruses is a matter of controversy because they show both characters like living organisms and the characters like non-living things. Which are characters like living organisms, which are characters like non-living things? First, characters like living organisms. In viruses, presence of nucleic acids, they can reproduce and have capacity to mutate. They have definite size and shape. They are sensitive to various environmental conditions. Now, characters like non-living things. No cellular organization, no independent metabolic system. They do not increase in size. They can be crystallized. So, here, this is about the virus introduction, history of viruses, and general characters of viruses.